on this and listening to every word. And I'm like, look, you got to be careful. I knew that when I was 13, 14 years old. Not as good as I do now in my mid-30s.
But yeah.
I knew something was going on then, you know, because you have to be, you know, some,
yeah.
Just be careful. That's
yeah.
what I can say.
I definitely like to find more positive music. As a child, I just, you know, as an adult, I definitely like music that has that whole "I'm sad about your girl leaving" kind of vibe to it.
Yeah.
I don't know why that makes me feel good about it. You know, say like Chicago and stuff like that. I really like that stuff. Man.
I listened to that, bro.
Yeah.
Chicago was a good band.
Yeah,
it's a really good song.
Man, I used to listen to a lot of Chicago, but I just give them a shout out to Chicago, Peter Cetera. What's up?
Yeah, I grew up listening to a lot of heavy metal music,
but
more positive kinds. Like, you know, a lot of this stuff, some of it's negative. Yeah, some of it has bad vibes, and a lot of it doesn't, though. Back in the 80s, though, it was a whole different scene when
I
was growing up.
Yeah,
I was listening to that.
Yeah, like...
That's when I was listening to it, back in the
80s,
early 90s.
Song came to my mind was Motley Crue, Dr. Feelgood.
That one actually has a good vibe.
That's why I said, because you said
it does have a good vibe in it.
That's why I said, that's the one that popped into my mind.
Dr. Feelgood. That song is about drug addiction.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And
but it was
a great song. Great album. Almost every song on that album is great.
Pumped
came out in 89. I remember buying that album when it came out.
I had the tape, not the CD. I remember the kid dressing up as Dr. Feelgood for Halloween.
Mm-hmm.
Be a doctor and just say Dr. Feelgood.
I don't even remember that.
Yeah.
The kids dressed up for that.
Yeah.
I did not know that.
I remember that as a young man. You know?
Dr. Feelgood.
Yeah, it was a thing to do, dress up like Dr. Feelgood.
Motley Crue is a great band.
Yeah.
They have some spiritual truth in their songs.
Oh, yeah.
Like, they have a song called, Home Sweet Home.
Oh, that's great.
Which has a lot of spiritual truth in it. Like, I recommend that people look at what's written in the lyrics. Might want to read it or listen to it while reading the lyrics.
Yeah, lyrics.
It'll help you with situations involving death of people and stuff that you know. Read the lyrics.
Yeah,
like, it'll help you. It does help with situations.
Because,
being there, right?
No, that's all right, because the musicians are very, like, they're wise too, you know, so wise in their lyrics, but they put stuff into the lyrics.
Sometimes they don't know what they're doing. Sometimes they're just hearing it in their mind.
Exactly.
That's the way Home Sweet Home came.
Well,
I know that psychically, that they just, Vince Neil started hearing it in his mind, the lyrics, and he started writing it, and it was just down on paper. Then he called, like, Nikki Sixx and then Tommy Lee, you gotta come to the studio, man. I got a great song.
Mm-hmm.
I can feel it psychically. I can see it playing through my mind.
Well, they got the
song.
It
came from the infinite.
The song should be interpreted definitely in a way, you know, that you hear it.
Yeah.
But you should definitely try to hear it, you know. Try to hear the lyrics. Each song, I mean, their songs are made just in dot light. But most songs, people are trying to say something, you know. And a lot of times, knowing that as a musician, I feel like I speak better through my music than I can with my mouth.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to, like, know that these people are coming out with the kicking the wisdom, you know.
They are, yeah.
You know, some of them, you know.
A lot of them are. A lot of them don't know they've kicked wisdom. You know,
yeah,
like, a lot of them might write, like, some song that doesn't seem like spirituality at all, but yet it is.
Oh, yeah.
It has, like, a hidden spiritual component from the infinite that they didn't know about when they wrote it, but it's there.
Like, for as far as sexual healing, like, I Want to Sex You Up.
Yeah.
That song, or Call Me Bad.
Yeah.
I want to sex you up.
I remember that.
Yeah, they really turned on the switch. Those kind of songs, like, I want to touch myself, not that girl, I can't remember.
Oh, I remember that song. He's like, she's singing like, I touch myself.
I don't want anybody else.
Yeah. When I think about you, I touch myself.
Yeah.
I remember that song. It was early 90s. I think it came out in like 91, maybe.
That's what
90 or 91.
It's almost like the sexual thing kind of moving. Like, I remember the song, I guess it don't matter what we're talking about.
That song about
like Wild Wild West.
Yeah, I remember that song.
Like, that was a real sexual song, you know. It just started getting out there. People started really wanting to do it, you know. Maybe it was just me in my mind or whatever. But it seemed like at that time it was like, yeah, this big sex drive going on here. it helped a lot of people, I think. Man. It opened a lot of people's minds. And,
it does.
Yeah, a lot of that stuff, man. Even music, shaking your body, wiggling your body and your extremities and your ass and everything.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying? that really gets people's vibe, you know, changed in a good way, you know.
It's like, go ahead.
I was just saying the can.
No, I was thinking the same thing on, like, I was feeling this on Saturday night, like, you know, it was just a psychic feeling coming from many different people around Richmond from their thoughts, and I was just more psychic is not a good word for that. Telepathic and empathic feeling I got from people's vibes. I can just sense in them, you know?
Yeah.
Like, you know, like this overall thing about going out to the club and dancing and drinking, and I could just feel the people's this hype up vibe and anticipation and whatnot.
Mm-hmm.
This energy, you know,
a good beat will really make you feel good, you know. It's more to music than meets the eye, you know. There's definitely stuff going on with music, and for many millions of years.
Oh yeah, that's for sure. You know,
it integrates spiritual healing, mental healing, sexual healing, all of that. You know, it all goes together. You know.
Well, I told Jeremy that there's lords of music out there. He could be a lord of music too. Like, you know, writing music, you know, and putting vibes up in it to do his bidding on people when people listen to do what needs to be done spiritually through the song. You know, that's what it can be done with it. It can rise to that level.
I try to write lyrics where people can get something from it. You know, definitely. Music is king.
You're a nut.
Yeah, it's all type of healing, you know. But I want to say, I made me want to write also the other forms of expression, like dancing, poetry,
mm-hmm.
dancing. I mean, these are all ways of healing. You know, talent is healing. You know, talent is healing, and
all of that.
Yeah, most people's talents, like we're touching on comedians and things like that. That's healing.
That is too, yeah. Good point. I didn't even think about that. Yeah, laughter and comedy.
Yeah, talent, you know, laughter.
I'm writing it down because it's something to touch out. Touch on like in a video too. That, you know, especially the con thing about that, the comedy thing.
Yeah, I mean, it's a part of the talent, you know. Well, that's what it boils down to, you know, music. I think, you know, if you say music has vibes, all talent has vibes. Good talent, like, you know, if your talent is,
whatever it is.
Yeah.
Well, this is something else to touch on. If you have a talent like that, don't ignore it.
Yeah.
You know, like, if you're good at comedy, this reminds me of somebody I know.
Yeah.
You know, that this is what we talked about on the video that didn't record the other day.
Yes.
I touched on this. But if you have a talent, you need to use it. You need to go ahead, and if you got a natural talent, step out and do it. Don't be afraid to use it. You know, use it for good purposes and step out there and do it as your life work. You know, like, don't be afraid to quit your job and leave things behind to pursue what you feel you're good at.
Balls to the wall.
Balls to the wall. That's a good way to put it. You can't, there's no looking back. Like, I think I read a verse of the Bible that came on yesterday on TV. Remember I clicked it on about, like, so remember that Christ said, no one who looks at the sky and touches the cloud or the sky needs spiritual enlightenment. No one who touches it then turns back around and looks behind them is fit for spiritual service. You know,
balls
to the wall. Whatever you do, if you're a spiritual teacher, balls to the wall. You know, if you're a comedian, go balls to the wall. Leave everything else behind and just do that. If you're a rapper, balls to the wall. Forget everything else but rap. You know, if you're a singer, sing. Balls to the wall.
That's right.
You know, sing. Do it.
Easier.
If you're a writer, balls to the wall.
Easier to give the advice than to take.
Right? And to take it, but it's important. Like, people who need it will see this video, I think. It'll come to the right people.
Yeah, do what your heart's telling you to do what you like.
Good way to put it.
Yeah.
Do what your heart and soul.
Yeah,
you know, like, let me write that in. That do it with your heart and soul. That's the words that popped up in my mind just now. Do it with your heart and with your heart.
Good way of putting it. So I'm gonna write the same thing.
Could be anything. It could be sex. I mean, if people can have sex with their heart and soul and write music. We're on the 20-minute thing.
Yeah.
Let me see where we're at. I think it's about 19 minutes.
Definitely.
1949. All right,
guys.
All right, we'll be right back with the third one. Peace.